I'm going to do a Bible reading for you today. And this comes from the New International Version. And I'll be reading Psalm 139. This Bible has been chewed by the dog a number of years ago. The dog is no longer with me. Not for that reason. I was given this Bible in 1984. And that means I've had it for quite some time. So it was just a little unfortunate that I left it where my little dog could get to it. But I'm sure she enjoyed feeding on the Word of God, as I hope you will. I think just before we start, if it's okay with you, I'll just say a little prayer. Dear God, I pray for those who are listening tonight or today, whatever time of day it is. I pray that as we read your Word, that they would have a sense of worth, that they would know that they are valued, that they are your treasures. Lord, each person is special and unique. I pray that you would grant each person peace and relieve any anxiety that they may be feeling at this moment. If they're having trouble sleeping, I pray that those difficulties would leave them and that they would have a calmness and be able to settle into a deep, peaceful sleep. I ask for your presence here. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's get started and find Psalm 139. In the Old Testament, so I'll keep going. Psalm 139. O Lord, you have searched me and you know me. You know me when I sit and when I rise. You perceive my thoughts from afar. You discern my going out and my lying down. You are familiar with all my ways. You know it completely, O Lord. You hem me in behind and before. You have laid your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, too lofty for me to attain. Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I make my bed in the depths, you are there. If I rise on the wings of the dawn, if I settle on the far side of the sea, even there your hand will guide me, your right hand will hold me fast. If I say, surely the darkness will hide me, and the light become night around me, even the darkness will not be dark to you. The night will shine like the day, for darkness is as light to you. For you created my inmost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. I know that full well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in the secret place. When I was woven together in the depths of the earth, your eyes saw my unformed body. All the days ordained for me were written in your book before one of them came to be. How precious to me are your thoughts, O God! How vast is the sum of them! Where do I count them? They would outnumber the grains of sand. When I awake, I am still with you. If only you would slay the wicked, O God. Away from me, you bloodthirsty men. They speak of you with evil intent. Your adversaries misuse your name. Do I not hate those who hate you, O Lord, and abhor those who rise up against you? I have nothing but hatred for them. I count them my enemies. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts. See if there is any offensive way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. One of the things I love about this psalm is how it speaks about how well God knows us. From sitting to when we rise, that speaks of so much entirety. From the sitting down to when we rise, it speaks of from the moment we wake up to the moment we stand up, to whether we're sitting, standing, sleeping. He knows us so well. And yes, that really is so wonderful, too wonderful for me to understand. Knowing that even before my mother knew she was expecting me, knowing all these things, that God knew me, God knew about my anxieties. He knew about anything that frightened me. He knew all the things that would give me joy. How precious. Please always remember that you are fearfully and wonderfully made. You are unique. You are treasured and cherished by the Almighty. And that is cause to feel at peace. God knows your anxieties, and He loves you.